Now, remember the days when owning your own home was a rite of passage, not a privilege?
Nope, I'm too young, but I certainly remember the motto, work hard, buy a house, that's the Kiwi way.
Yes, well now it seems the struggle isn't just finding the money to buy or to build, it's also making sure you get the right help to turn your dreams into reality. Jill explains.
Behind every for sale sign, there's a story of hard work.
The foundations have been done and the retaining wall at the back.
Exciting plans.
Oh, wow.
The vista.
Oh, that is amazing.
And sometimes, sorrow.
They wanted to build their dream home.
This is all that's left of Sonia's parents' project. It was a rebuild of the old farmhouse they'd lived in for 42 years that was wrecked by a Christchurch earthquake.
My parents felt a real connection to this place and, it's broken their hearts, really.
Heartbreak caused when the rebuild came to a sudden stop and their savings were gone.
We're talking about $500,000. They thought they were in safe hands and I think nothing could have been further from the truth.
Did you take sugar?
With their property up for sale, Iain and Yvonne have moved into a small unit they half own with Yvonne's brother.
Yeah, we're hoping to get enough to pay his half out.
They feel pretty stupid.
I'm very annoyed with myself. I should have made more checks.
But they also feel cheated by the project manager involved.
Just the time he's taken off me. Time with my grandchildren that should have been coming to stay with us.
It's cruel. What he's done is so cruel.
This is their project manager, Andrew Shepherdson. Here are his impressive credentials and his former company, Build Ecology Limited, that the Wilkinsons put their trust in to do the job.
He knows exactly what he's doing. This is not some builder that's been caught short.
After the 2011 quake, Shepherdson worked as an expert witness for insurance companies, but then
decided that he couldn't live with that anymore.
So he switched sides and was recommended to Yvonne and Iain for their claim for earthquake damage.
He was very thorough. He picked up a lot of stuff we would never have known.
Then another change of career.
Andrew wanted to get out of that line of business and start, he said he wanted to start building.
So they agreed, happily getting on with their lives and developing a friendship.
My mum had been up there with a fruitcake for them for Christmas.
The foundations and retaining wall were completed and then these SIPS panels arrived.
They speed up the build, basically. They come with the insulation inside.
But there was a problem. The SIPS supplier says the panels were inspected on site and told Shepherdson the panels were wet, compromised and needed replacing at Build Ecology's expense.
Just swept it under the rug and kept going.
That wasn't the only message that they say didn't get passed on. The build failed 3 council inspections, but instead of admitting any mistakes, Build Ecology issued a new contract.
He continued to say that, you know, things were very expensive and that he needed more money for the other trades and materials. Gave hugs and promises to the last.
Then the news that changed everything.
Another elderly couple contacted my parents to say that they had been to the police to register a fraud case against Andrew Shepherdson for their build, and I understand it was a very similar amount of money.
So then when did the problem actually become clearer?
My parents starting to contact the different suppliers and realising that the money hadn't been paid to those suppliers.
The completed work had cost $350,000, but an additional $500,000 was unaccounted for.
This is my parents' life savings.
So all up, more than $800,000. So the Wilkinsons got lawyers on board and took Andrew Shepherdson's company to mediation, except
a week before the mediation date, he went into liquidation.
From belly up to wheels up, Shepherdson then left for the UK.
He has never been in contact with my parents to say sorry or express any remorse. I feel that he played them perfectly.
Within days, Yvonne had a stress-induced mini stroke and now has difficulty expressing herself.
I'm thoroughly annoyed when I can't do that.
Sorry, doesn't make me quite emotional. It's been such a long road.
and no end in sight. A year on, the liquidators say they're still investigating. The police say as fraud cases are complicated, they still don't know if they'll act on the case. And neither the police or the liquidator knew of his whereabouts. But we tracked Shepherdson down in London. So we got our Europe correspondent to give him a call.
I just want to ask you what you've done with the $500,000 belonging to Iain and Yvonne Wilkinson.
I haven't took anything from them.
We knew the Wilkinsons would want to hear this.
I haven't done anything, and it's all with the liquidator and everything like that has been done honestly, and there was nothing. And I wasn't paid by other people, and my business folded.
So why didn't you finish the house for them?
The house couldn't be finished.
Why?
So it's just not true.
I believed him, unfortunately.
With so much still unanswered, Daniel Fytower approached Shepherdson's listed company address, but Shepherdson involved his lawyer, ordering Daniel away, saying his presence was traumatising.
We've been through trauma.
Well, he's brought it on himself.
Well, he has. He's got questions that need answering. Hopefully the next people who knock on his door will be the police.
Shepherdson's lawyer then got in touch denying all claims of wrongdoing, saying the payments the Wilkinsons made to his company, Build Ecology, were in line with their contract and properly recorded in the company's accounts. Why then can't they give the Wilkinsons a full breakdown, something they've asked for repeatedly? Sonia believes Fairgo's involvement at least sped things up with police. She called to say they met with them today, but bad news, they're not going ahead with the case.
It's frustrating.
Police say there's no evidence of money being taken overseas or personal spending, just bad management. It's devastating for the Wilkinsons, who've lost so much, but these good people want to help prevent such a disaster happening to others.
Part of the reason why things went on so long is that all of the information about the council inspections went directly to Andrew Shepherdson.
So they want all inspections to go to homeowners by default for a chance to pick up problems early. An idea we took to Christchurch City Council.
It's not a difficult thing if we start sending them to the owner as default.
So they have your word that this will be done?
Correct, yep. I think everyone needs a fair go.
It is an achievement, and something at least to make the Wilkinsons feel good.
I am grateful to Fair Go, and I'm grateful to the council for them looking at that. I think that will make a difference.
Oh, that has been a tough road, all right. So we're pleased there's at least something positive to come out of it.
Yeah, thanks to the Wilkinsons, Christchurch City Council has changed its building consent process. So now all building inspection results get emailed to the property owners by default. But you would have thought, why is this not happening already?